Hi guys, in the previous video we've modeled and texture our basic arch in Blender and Substance Painter. So in this video we are gonna follow a slightly different approach for how to texture our arc that we modeled. Now we've got this. I'm starting with baking my mesh maps. I've just baked them. Okay, now I'm going into my project. This is where I will be finding my mesh map. Okay, now I'm going to the layers. I'm deleting the default layer, adding two fill layers and a paint layer. Now first I'm disabling it. I'm going there and I'm in this above fill layer. I'm not gonna work on any of these maps and I'm just dragging my thickness map over there and see the difference if I did not use the thickness and if I use the thickness map. Okay, done. Now go to the fill layer 1. Now I am gonna make this a bit yellowish and I am gonna change this blend mode to multiply so you can see this, and it would be better if I increase the roughness values to get this look. Okay, now what I am gonna do is go to now I'm gonna duplicate this layer. Yeah, and I'm gonna make it a bit darker and I went to the smart masks and I drag this mask on that and this is what the look that we get. So yeah, I am pretty much satisfied with this. And actually there is something, so yeah, this is fine. Now let's see something that will help us. Now let's add some cracks to our model. Yeah, go to the layer 1 and add paint. Now in this particular case I am just gonna work on height. So just I'm gonna work on height. I just reduced it a bit and I went to brushes and I clicked on cracks. I'm enabling this layer and see, when I click on it you are finding cracks, right? See, and for that you have to go there in the blend modes and just see, there are different options that you can, you know, play around, but see, just click it. If you reduce the height value and click it, see, you're finding cracks on edges. See, yeah, that's it. And if you want to add a bit more effect, you can go to materials and add some material to that and you can paint it. See, that's how it is done. And if you, even though if you can, you can try different options. There are different blending modes over here and you have to experiment it for yourself and learn. These techniques can be used in many ways. So that's it for this video, and I'll be trying to make some more improvements with my techniques, and I'll be coming up with modeling different types of assets like trees, rocks, etc. in the near future. Stay tuned, and